Employers of Reddit, what was the worst way you ever saw somebody react to getting fired? I was managing a small cell phone store in a strip mall kind of place a few years back and only had a couple employees under me. This one guy would come in late all the time, generally put no effort in, etc. and I basically laid down the law with him after a couple weeks and told him to shape up or get fired. He got better for like a week, then showed up late again. I don't mean like 5 minutes late, I mean like 2 hours late. He gave me some bullshit excuse. I warned him and told him I'd fire him next time he showed up more than 5 minutes late. He told me to stop being so uptight and to get the stick out of my ass, so I told him to get himself out of my store. He walks out of the store, goes out to his car, gets a baseball bat out of the trunk, walks over to my car, and proceeds to basically smash the ever-living shit out of my car. Now this little strip mall is literally right across the street from the police station, so as soon as he grabbed the bat, I called the local PD. They come over within probably 90 seconds and arrest him. Fantastic response time, but not good enough. I drove a half decent car at the time worth around $7K, and the car was basically totaled. I couldn't believe how much havoc he wreaked on that car in 90 seconds. Smashed every window, both headlights, fucked up the hood slash fenders, broke my spoiler in half. It was astonishing. Long story short, the guy ended up getting a felony charge and serving jail time, in addition to having to pay reparations. I ended up getting cut a check from my insurance company and buying a newer model of the same car, but parked it around the back so customer slash employees wouldn't know what kind of car I had. Something like fool me once, shame on you, fool me twice, shame on me, TLDR. Fired a guy for chronic lateness slash bad attitude. He destroyed my car with a baseball bat in the parking lot across the street from the police station and got arrested slash convicted of a felony. I was managing a small cell phone store in a strip mall kind of place a few years back and only had a couple employees under me. This one guy would come in late all the time, generally put no effort in, etc. and I basically laid down the law with him after a couple weeks and told him to shape up or get fired. He got better for like a week, then showed up late again. I don't mean like 5 minutes late, I mean like 2 hours late. He gave me some bullshit excuse. I warned him and told him I'd fire him next time he showed up more than 5 minutes late. He told me to stop being so uptight and to get the stick out of my ass, so I told him to get himself out of my store. He walks out of the store, goes out to his car, gets a baseball bat out of the trunk, walks over to my car, and proceeds to basically smash the ever-living shit out of my car. Now this little strip mall is literally right across the street from the police station, so as soon as he grabbed the bat, I called the local PD. They come over within probably 90 seconds and arrest him. Fantastic response time, but not good enough. I drove a half decent car at the time worth around $7K, and the car was basically totaled. I couldn't believe how much havoc he wreaked on that car in 90 seconds. Smashed every window, both headlights, fucked up the hood slash fenders, broke my spoiler in half. It was astonishing. Long story short, the guy ended up getting a felony charge and serving jail time, in addition to having to pay reparations. I ended up getting cut a check from my insurance company and buying a newer model of the same car, but parked it around the back so customer slash employees wouldn't know what kind of car I had. Something like fool me once, shame on you, fool me twice, shame on me, TLDR. Fired a guy for chronic lateness slash bad attitude. He destroyed my car with a baseball bat in the parking lot across the street from the police station and got arrested slash convicted of a felony. I caught the assistant manager absent from the store while clocked in. I asked the girl working the front counter, and she said that this bitch was leaving for several hours of every single shift, but claimed she was clocking out. Wold fired her either way for leaving without permission so often. But I went through and watched the video and checked her timecodes, and she was constantly leaving for hours without clocking out. I waited for her for almost an hour, and she showed back up right when her shift was supposed to end, I'm guessing to clock out and keep the charade up. I asked her what was up, and she told me she had just left to give her sister a ride to work across town, and that she must have somehow forgotten to clock out for it. I told her that I had been watching the videos, and she immediately looked at the other girl who had been working alone in her absence, and slammed her fists down on the counter, and called her a cunt. I told her that the other girl had actually tried to cover for her, and was facing discipline herself. I asked for her keys and shirts and she claimed she didn't have any of it. I told her to go home, and get it all immediately, or she would be charged for it on her final check. She showed back up several hours later, and after I had sent the other girl home, and called in a friend, to help me at the store. She walked in the door, called me a stupid ass honky, she isn't white, threw her shirts on the floor, and threw her keys across the store, scattering them. Then she started crying, and called me a lying sack of shit, and saying that her, and her kids were going to go homeless because of me. I told her she shouldn't have cheated the company. That made her explode, knocking shit off the counter, screaming, threatening my family. Luckily the buddy I called in stepped between, and handed her a note. She looked at him, ripped it in half, and dropped it as she walked out. When I picked up the note, it was a criminal trespass form he had filled out with her information, and presented to her, essentially banning her from the property under threat of arrest. I'm frankly surprised that that got her to leave, but whatever works, works. I was a security officer at a large aerospace company, one that makes fighter jets and the decks they fly off of, if you want to know. One guy got wind of his termination, and got a large power drill, and drilled holes in several aircraft skins. Now considering that these skins never cost less than $50,000 each, he did a lot of damage. They could not be salvaged either. Another employee, who wasn't being fired, but reassigned to another job, same pay etc, jumped off the top floor of a 5-story building. The security officer who was 50 feet away from his landing point took a stress retirement. He said he'd never forget that sound. Not an employer, but my boyfriend had a co-worker get fired for repeatedly just not showing up for work. They worked at a small chain gas station / store type place that required all employees to wear a necklace with a small button to call police in emergencies. This necklace would only work within a 50-foot radius of the store, but could be used in any one of the 10-plus stores. Well, this guy keeps his necklace, and decides to go out one day, driving slowly past each store, while pressing the button. The police, being required to go, ended up showing up at every store, until they realized what was going on. I'm not an employer, but this is kind of related. I was in a small supermarket buying some groceries after work and this customer asked someone over to help him with a self-service machine. The customer wasn't aggressive or rude, and he just commented on the machine, "This damn thing's never worked for me," in a joking manner or something like that. And the staff member went crazy, got in his face, and was yelling, "Don't disrespect me, bruv," and all this London wannabe gangster shit. Like completely went off the deep end. So the customer called over a manager, and this kid was still going off at the customer right in front of the manager. The customer walked out saying he was going to file a complaint. Then this kid starts saying to the manager that the customer was making it all up, and he had done nothing wrong. Even thought he had been threatening the customer with violence in front of the manager. Then when the manager told his that he didn't believe him, the kid then threatened to stab the manager for not believing him. Once a guy got fired from a supermarket I was at. He was a weird guy who worked part-time while he worked in a slaughterhouse. He got fired because he just would drift off for like 20 minutes in the back just sitting around doing nothing. When he got sacked, well, he didn't get his contract renewed after his initial training month. He acted like he knew it was coming. He just said, "I'm going to the bathroom," and my boss who was with him was a little taken aback, but was like, "Yeah, fine." After about 20 minutes he's still in there, and my boss goes to check on him. He was just sitting in there having a wank. The cubicle door was shut, but my boss swung it open revealing Slaughterhouse Tom taking care of his own meat. Apparently my boss just walked out, and 5 minutes later the guy come out, and left never to be seen again. It was the first person I ever fired. An 18-year-old college dropout who lasted 1.5 shifts, and was obviously carting a whole lot of drama with her, and I want dealing with that. So I tell her that we are releasing her from her probationary period, and I swear her head popped open and a shining ball of crazy came flying out. She goes on to say she hates her job and wants to slap a customer with a cookie. I ask her why she told me she loved food service in her interview, and she said she knows the only way to get anywhere is by lying, and she learned that from her father, who makes 6 figures a year. So excuse me if she doesn't take my word for it. And if she told me in her interview that she dropped out of college because of her pill addiction, then I never would have hired her. Really, it reminded me of a bad breakup in high school more than anything. After she finally left the room, my senior manager who had helped me break the news to her turns to me and says, "That was the worst reaction I've ever gotten, by far." Not fired, but as a line cook, I was working on Saturday night in the middle of the dinner rush. Someone asked where the dishwasher was. Sure enough, he had enough, took off his apron and walked out. You want to fuck up a restaurant, believe it or not. Taking the dishwasher in the middle of a Saturday service is a real good way to fuck them over. The fired employee punched me in the side of the head while my back was turned, then proceeded to kick me repeatedly with his steel toe boots for over a minute before he was pushed off me. This was in the middle of a warehouse in front of others at lunchtime. I went to the emergency room and miraculously had no injuries or sign of concussion outside of a burst blood vessel in my eye and black and blue splotches all over. He was high on pills that he later admitted he didn't even know what was in them. He was fired because an hour earlier he threatened me and then said he knew where my house was and my kids. He wasn't a psychopath, but he had a serious drug problem, and that was the last straw. He's also one of those guys that was incredibly smart, but was raised by relatives and grew up in a country ghetto. We let go one of our paramedics, and she lost her shit in the middle of the office, cursing everyone out. She then directed her hate at the seer whose door was shut, but he has a window. He saw her pointing towards him, not knowing why, so he smiled and waved. This did not help matters. She called him a rumpelstiltskin looking motherfucker, and slammed the door, and smoked a joint in the parking lot. The most amusing one was the guy who said okay, went back to his desk, and started taking calls again. Had to tell him we meant immediately. Not an employer, but a great reaction from the person doing the firing. I was either fired or laid off for no real reason from a major financial firm. It's been years, and I'm still not sure. I saw it coming from a mile away. They just didn't like me and had been trying to find a reason to get rid of me for about 6 months prior. Through an odd series of events, I was able to predict almost to the day that I was either going to get fired or laid off. On that day, I was called into the super senior manager's office. I knew what was coming, so I quietly left my desk and took my coat, my bag, and packed the 2 or 3 things that I wanted to keep from my desk. I was huge relief that I was never going to have to go back there again. I get into his office and he noticed that I had brought stuff with me and had my building badge in hand ready to give to him. He said something along the lines of, "You brought your coat?" As soon as I walked in, I smiled and said, "It's a bit chilly out today." Then he told me I was being let go and cited some completely stupid reason. I smiled and said something like, "Thanks for putting up with me for the last couple years." Shortly after that, it sank into him that I knew it was coming from a mile away. This didn't sit well with him at all. He then proceeded to start yelling and screaming and slamming his hands on the table in the room. He slammed his hand on the table so hard in the room that he was trying to hide the fact that he hurt himself for the rest of the conversation. I was relieved I would never have to go back there, and trying not to laugh. About a year later, that same guy friended me on LinkedIn. Go figure. Not an employer, but a great reaction from the person doing the firing. I was either fired or laid off for no real reason from a major financial firm. It's been years, and I'm still not sure. I saw it coming from a mile away. They just didn't like me and had been trying to find a reason to get rid of me for about 6 months prior. Through an odd series of events, I was able to predict almost to the day that I was either going to get fired or laid off. On that day, I was called into the super senior manager's office. I knew what was coming, so I quietly left my desk and took my coat, my bag, and packed the 2 or 3 things that I wanted to keep from my desk. I was huge relief that I was never going to have to go back there again. I get into his office and he noticed that I had brought stuff with me and had my building badge in hand ready to give to him. He said something along the lines of, "You brought your coat?" As soon as I walked in, I smiled and said it's a bit chilly out today. Then he told me I was being let go, and cited some completely stupid reason. I smiled and said something like, thanks for putting up with me for the last couple years. Shortly after that, it sank into him that I knew it was coming from a mile away. This didn't sit well with him at all. He then proceeded to start yelling and screaming and slamming his hands on the table in the room. He slammed his hand on the table so hard in the room that he was trying to hide the fact that he hurt himself for the rest of the conversation. I was relieved I would never have to go back there, and trying not to laugh. About a year later, that same guy friended me on LinkedIn. Go figure.